professor in Department of Civil Engineering, and I'll be the coordinator of this webinar program. On behalf of the Department of Civil Engineering, SBC, I'm happy to welcome you all to the international webinar on advanced aerated concrete of concrete technology and its application. Now, I am delighted to introduce our speaker, Mr. Shivaram Kumar. Welcome, sir. Now I'll give you a brief introduction about sir. He is working as a director of technical operations at Lucas Industry International, Berlin, Germany, for the past 12 years. Earlier, he was working at various organizations in New Delhi, including Feedback Ventures Private Limited, one of the reputed and leading consultancy company on roads, bridges, and environment in India. He completed his master's in environmental engineering at Technical University Hamburg, Germany. Earlier, he did his postgraduate diploma in operation research at CEG campus, Chennai. He completed his UG in Madurai Kamaraj University with University 6th rank. And he is also a life member of Indian Concrete Institute. He is specialized in lightweight concrete, especially foam-based aerated concrete. His company, Luca Industries International, is a worldwide renowned company in biotechnology-based foaming agents. And this company is supplying high-quality equipments, additives, technologies to produce lightweight aerated concrete under the brand name of Lithopore and Lithofoam. Lucas Industries International is the only company in the world that has developed the technology to produce concrete at a 75 kilogram per meter cube density. When compared with the conventional concrete, it is the density will be higher at a range of 2,400 kilogram per meter cube. And he has traveled all over the company to train the people to produce higher quality lithopore aerated concrete using their technology. I'm sure that you will feel enriched with knowledge in aerated concrete after attending this webinar. Once again, I will welcome you all to the webinar on advanced aerated concrete technology and its application. And thank you, sir. Yeah. Without any delay, I hand over the session to the speaker.
Thank you, Satyendriya.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome all. Just a minute before starting, let me share the presentation. Is it visible? Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Am I audible also?
Yes, sir.
Can everyone hear you? Hear me? Okay. Okay.
Yes.
Thanks for everyone for participating in this webinar, and thanks Ms. Satyapriya for organizing this webinar for, you know, distributing this knowledge to the concerned persons. Let me introduce my company. Basically, I am working for this company called Luca Industries International, GmbH. It's based in Berlin, in Germany. Our company is, you know, well versed in biotechnological process. They manufacture, you know, various chemicals using biotechnology, and one such technology is lithopore aerated concrete technology. So I'll be giving you a detailed, you know, knowledge on what is this aerated concrete, and you know how we are manufacturing this, and what are the applications that you can do using this technology, and all I can share it with you. I hope it will be interesting to you. Before I move on to the presentation. This is the overall presentation topics that I am going to cover. So first thing that I'm going to cover is the types of lightweight concrete and definition of this lightweight concrete, and then composition and types of ingredients that are being used for manufacturing this lithopore aerated concrete, and then the manufacturing process itself. And we'll also be seeing what are its properties and advantages, and then the at last the applications, what are the applications that we can use with this technology. So moving on to this lightweight concrete, you know, many would have heard about this concrete, but you may not be having a detailed idea or detailed knowledge about this concrete. So basically, you heard about this conventional concrete, which is composition of cement, fine aggregate, and coarse aggregate. So in lightweight concrete, basically the idea is to reduce the density of the concrete, which is conventionally 2400 to 2500 kilogram per cubic meter. So by reducing this density, there are many advantages. You know, mostly you can use it for structural applications as well as non-structural applications for using this lightweight concrete. So when it comes to structural applications or structural lightweight concrete, this is the major two types of lightweight concrete, you can say, the structural lightweight concrete and non-structural lightweight concrete. So this structural lightweight concrete, you can say also as lightweight aggregate concrete. So the as you can see in the name itself, instead of using the heavier aggregate, so in this concrete, they normally use lightweight aggregate. So this aggregate can be both coarse aggregate as well as fine aggregate. So these are the few different aggregates that you can use normally. So natural aggregates like vermiculite, perlite, like that, and then pumice, cinder, scoria, all those aggregates are naturally occurring. It's basically in volcanic regions, these kinds of aggregates are available. So in these aggregates, it has got naturally pores inside, so that makes the aggregate very lightweight when compared to the granites that are available in India. So apart from natural aggregates, there are manufactured aggregates also, so which is called rotarical expanded clay or shale, and then sintered expanded clay or shale, and then sintered slag or pulverized fuel ash as well as fly ash. So all these three are manufactured aggregates using clay and waste raw materials that are coming out of the industries. So this clay, when it is being put in a process called rotary kiln or sintering process, this clay gets expanded and it has got lots of pores inside. So that's why it has got lighter in weight, but at the same time it has got very good strength. So this structural lightweight concrete, basically you are just replacing the finer or coarse aggregate, or both. You can replace both coarse aggregate as well as fine aggregate with the lightweight aggregate. So once you do that, then you can call that as a lightweight aggregate concrete. Normally the density of this concrete will be anything below 1800 kilogram per cubic meter, and you can go up to 600 or 700 kilogram per cubic meter density. So the first natural aggregates as well as this polystyrene beads, basically these aggregates, if you use, you can achieve very light concrete, like in between 600 to 1000 kilogram per cubic meter, whereas the rotary kiln expanded clay or sintered expanded clay, These aggregates are used for higher density as well as high strength applications. So the advantage in using this lightweight aggregate is that you can achieve similar strength of concrete equivalent to the conventional concrete like M30, M40. Sometimes you can achieve M50 also with this manufactured aggregates, but using natural aggregates you cannot achieve that much strength, but with manufactured aggregates you can definitely achieve very high strength. So there are many applications that were earlier used even in Second World War. America has used this lightweight concrete for making ships. They built the ships using this lightweight aggregate concrete, and they have used these ships for commercial transport of many things like oil. They use this ship for transporting grains and all such materials that are being transported from America to US, to the US to Europe for war in Germany. So to supply the food and everything, essential things, they use this ship because at the time the steel availability was very limited in the US. So for that reason they have used this lightweight concrete for shipbuilding, and these ships are used to carry from 40 tons to even 300 tons of raw materials. So all this is proven, and even in the US they have tested this concrete for even nuclear explosion tests. Normally they conduct the test what will happen when there is a building exposed to nuclear explosion. So they even tested it, and they have found that this buildings that were built using this lightweight concrete are more durable than the conventional building materials like bricks and wood and everything. So this kind of lightweight aggregate concrete may be new to India, but it's a very, very old technology in Europe as well as in the US. So moving on to the next application, like non-structural lightweight concrete, there are two technologies in this. So we used to call this as aerated or cellular concrete. One is autoclaved or non-autoclaved aerated concrete or gas concrete, and the next is cellular or foam-based concrete. So the main difference between these two non-structural lightweight concrete technology is that in autoclaved concrete technology, they use only cement and very fine aggregate. Normally they use fly ash at the maximum if it is available easily, or they use sand, but this sand is being powdered or grained very fine. And so they use this two cement as well as this fine aggregate, and then they used basically this aluminium powder for creating the gas or aeration. So this aluminium powder, once you add it, it will create a chemical reaction, and that chemical reaction basically expands the concrete. And to make that curing faster as well as to retain that structure of the aeration, so normally they use autoclaving chambers. So autoclaving chamber, if no one knows, basically it is a chamber where high pressure and high temperature steam is being induced in this concrete blocks for very quick curing process of this concrete. So normally once you cast the concrete in a mold, they will keep it some time for drying, and then once you demold it, then it will be sent inside this autoclaving chamber for curing. So after a few hours, like about 10 hours of curing, they'll take this block out and then they'll pack it and then they'll ship it to the clients. So that's quick, the curing processes. Whereas in cellular or foam-based concrete, instead of aluminium powder, they normally use mechanical process of foam. So they create the foam using mechanical process like foam generators. So these foam generators and everything we will see in the later part. So this whole presentation, you know, is going to be about cellular or foam-based concrete technology. So that is the technology that we are pioneer on. So out of this all types of lightweight concrete, this presentation is going to be cellular or foam-based concrete. So this is a small introduction about our company. Basically, we work in the field of cellular or foam concrete technology. And as I said earlier, we have got biotechnological process. We basically produce this foaming chemical using this bioengineering process. And we use that chemical for producing the foam, and that foam is being used inside this concrete. So basically we offer for producing this cellular concrete, we offer machinery manufacturing. We ourselves manufacture all the machineries. We supply chemical additives, and we also do production and supervision of supplied machines. And also, if you need any improvement in the properties of cellular concrete, that also we do. And then we also do customer sales promotion, in the sense after you produce the blocks or after you produce the lithopore aerated concrete, we also help our customers to how to sell these products in the market. And also we train this lithopore technology for using this lithopore academy. We have this lithopore academy also, wherein we kept that for training of our customers as well as for outsiders. So now we see the definition. So far we have seen what are the types of lightweight concrete. Now we are going to see what is the definition of lightweight concrete. So generally, you know, this cellular concrete, basically there are different names. We call it a cellular lightweight concrete or non-autoclaved aerated concrete or aerated lightweight concrete, etc. So there are many names, but all this refers to the same foam-based concrete. And this is the definition that for this aerated concrete. Basically, any concrete or cement slurry that has a cementitious material having minimum of 20% of mechanically entrained foam in the plastic cement based mortar. So basically, as I said, in this cellular concrete, we use only cement and fine aggregate. So obviously this should be called as mortar, but somehow right from the early stages, this has been basically called it as lightweight concrete. So many will not accept it as a mortar, but it's been accepted as aerated concrete, even though it has got only the mortar content in it. So in this cement mortar, if you have 20% of minimum volume of the entire concrete with the mechanically entrained foam, then you can call it as a aerated concrete. But typically any aerated concrete, if you take minimum, it will have 40 to 80% of the total volume with the foam. So that's how they normally use it, because with 20%, it will have only the density of around 1,800 kilogram per cubic meter. It will not be much of the help. So the lighter version, the more foam content will be the widely used aerated concrete. So in this, if you can see, there are lots of bubbles. If you put this aerated concrete under a microscope, you can see there are lots of pores inside. So these pores are nothing but the foam bubbles that are being mixed along with the cement slurry. So these bubbles basically are surrounded with the cement. You can see the very clearly it is all surrounded with cement layer. So as soon as the cement starts setting, it forms the same bubble structure, and that's how it retains that aerated structure. So normally the bubble size of these aerated concrete will have around 0.1 to 1.5 millimeter diameter, but most of the aerated concrete, if you say for better quality, it is always better to have as low bubble size as possible, because that will give higher strength as well as better stability of the concrete. So it is always better to keep as small bubble size as possible. So this basically bubble size is actually helping the concrete for coalescence. Basically it helps the concrete to fill in every nook and corners of the mold. So this bubble structure is also useful for like a ball bearing effect to the concrete. So that's also one of the advantage of using this foam concrete. Now we see as I have said, this Lithopore is basically the brand name of our company, and there are many different foam concretes available in the market. So when you take our concrete technology with other concrete technology, these are the differences, or these are the comparison that you can say. So here, if you see in Lithopore aerated concrete technology, the foaming agent type is basically synthetic protein. So this synthetic protein is basically it's a protein that was manufactured using biotechnological process. So we can say it is artificial protein, but even though it is artificial, it is totally biodegradable. So it's totally environmental friendly way of manufacturing. Whereas the other foam concrete, they use either extracted protein, or sometimes they use chemical based foaming agents. So the main difference between the synthetic protein and extracted protein is that in synthetic protein, the properties will not change. The protein content, the amount of protein, everything is constant always, because when we manufacture, we know exactly how much percentage of foam, how much percentage of protein has to be added inside the foaming chemical. Whereas in extracted protein, what they do is they normally extract these proteins from the dead animals. So after slaughtering of the animals, or any dead animals, if you see, you have the horns and other waste out of this slaughtering of animals. So from these waste, they extract the protein using acid hydrolysis process. And when you extract this protein, you cannot be able to judge, or you cannot be able to exactly say how much protein content is there inside the extraction of this process. So sometimes you will have very good amount of protein, or sometimes you will have a lesser quantity of protein. So based on that, the foaming agent quality will also differ. If that particular batch of foaming agent has got good amount of protein, then it will give very good foaming effect. Whereas if it not has any protein content, then it will have bad quality of foaming effect. So this is the major difference in the foaming agent type. So our technology is fully synthetic based protein content, but still we don't harm any animals, and it's purely a manufacturing process. And so it is very precise of protein content. Every batch of foaming agents that we have, it's totally same quality. And we can also ensure that it's totally soluble protein content. Whereas the other foam concrete technology providers, they when they use extractor protein, all these proteins are not soluble. It's a settleable kind of a protein content. So every time you need to mix the foaming agent thoroughly before producing the foam. So, and also this extractor protein will not last for a long time. After a few months, it started degradation, and so it may degrade after some time. Before that, you have to use it. Whereas in synthetic protein based our foaming agent, it will not degrade so easily, unless you mix that foaming chemical with water. So as soon as you mix it with water, it starts degradation. But when you store this foaming agent without direct sunlight and water, then you can keep it for a very long time. And also our protein based foaming agent will not give very bad smell, whereas the other protein extracted protein based foaming agent has got very bad smell, and it is also acidic in nature, so it's not very healthy. Apart from the foaming agent, we also supply other additives. So like any concrete, you need additives for enhancing the strength or enhancing the flowability of the concrete and all. So you use lots of additives like plasticizers and everything. So similarly, we also supply additives, but these additives will not directly react with the cement or any raw materials inside the aerated concrete like sand or fly ash. But these additives directly react with our foaming agent only. So what it will do is basically it stabilizes our foaming agent. And so using these stabilizer and network former, you can achieve very high strength. And at the same time, as you know, any lightweight concrete is very vulnerable to cracks. So using our stabilizer chemical, you can easily arrest these cracks, and you can always be sure that our concrete is crack proof or crackless. So next major difference is the foaming system. So as I said earlier, to create the foam, you need a mechanical foam generator. So this foam generator is nothing but a mixture of air, water and foaming chemical. So for air, you need a air compressor to produce the air. And for water, you will be using water pump, and then you will be using the foaming agent. So when you mix all these three, you will get the foam automatically. And in our foaming system, basically the air compressor that we use is a very compact one. It uses a very low pressure air compressor, and it uses only 0.5 bar pressure. Whereas the other foam concrete technologies, they use compressed air system, which is more than 3 bar pressure and all. So using this low bar air pressure, we create a very stable foam. Whereas if you use the other foam generator, our foaming chemical will not work because they use very high air compressor, high air pressure. And when it comes to density range, you can see using our chemicals and foaming agents, you can bring down the concrete density to just 75 kilogram per cubic meter. So this is one of the most lightest weight of concrete that was ever produced, and we are very popular and very pioneer in producing that range of density, because many people cannot achieve 75 kilogram per cubic meter density, because in 75 kilogram per cubic meter density you use only 50 kilograms of cement, and the rest is all the foam. So unless your foam is very stable, you cannot achieve this density. So that's one of our major advantage, and with such low density concrete you can achieve very high thermal insulation value. So that's the main reason why we are reducing this density to such low thing, so that you will achieve very good thermal insulation properties of the concrete, so that you can use it for insulating your buildings. And the next comparison is the compressive strength. So if you take 600 kilogram cubic meter of our Lithopur aerated concrete, and if you take the concrete produced by other technology, we have achieved very high strength, which is 3 to 4 megapascals, whereas the other technologies, they can only achieve 1 to 2 megapascals. And as I said, our stability of foam as well as the concrete itself is more stable. It will not, you know, the bubbles will not collapse very easily. So you will not face the problem of settling of this concrete after you pour it into the molds. So whereas the other technologies, they have very low stability foam. And so their concrete will settle or reduce the volume very easily after some time. And next comparison is basically that the equipments that we provide, it's totally complete system that we provide. We don't just provide only the foaming chemical like that. We actually provide the complete system for manufacturing this aerated concrete. So what do we mean by complete system is we supply the foaming chemical, we supply the foam generator suitable for this foaming chemicals. And then we also supply the mixing system, because it is very important that this concrete cannot be produced in conventional concrete mixture. We have made a specialized mixtures for creating this for manufacturing this aerated concrete, because when we use foam, you know, once you add this foam into this cement slurry, the foam always stays on top of the cement slurry, whereas in normal concrete mixture you can see they use only heavier aggregates. So obviously all the aggregates will go inside the concrete mixture as soon as you add it into the mixture, whereas the foam always stays on top. So there is no mechanism in the conventional concrete mixture to push this foam inside the cement slurry, whereas we have created the mixture that actually mixes this foam and homogeneously it will get mixed inside the cement slurry, and so you will get the minimum damage of foam, as well as it will also take care of the stability of the concrete. So that's the most advantage of going with our technology. And apart from this foam generator and this mixture, we also supply the pump, specialized lightweight concrete pump, because you cannot use the normal conventional concrete pump, because they use very high pressure to pump this concrete, whereas our concrete pump is totally different. It takes care of the bubbles, because bubbles will get broken very easily if you pressurize this concrete. So we have specialized concrete mixtures, specialized concrete pumps. And also we also supply the cutting system if you want to manufacture blocks and all. So that also we supply separately. So that's why we call this as a complete system, so that we guarantee the quality of the lithopore aerated concrete as well as the end product that you are going to manufacture. Whereas the other concrete technology, foam concrete technology providers, they supply mainly only foaming agents. Sometimes they also give equipments, but their equipments is not complete one, so you will not achieve the high quality of the concrete. So that's the one of the major difference that we can say. And next, we always ensure that local raw material qualities, or what type of raw materials that you can use to achieve certain qualities of lightweight concrete. So when you approach us, we always ask you to send us the sample of your locally available raw material so that we can test it in our own laboratory, and we can tell you exactly what mixed design you can use to achieve particular strength and particular density of the concrete. Whereas the others, they don't consider all these factors. They simply supply the technology and they'll ask you to do it on trial basis, whatever quality that you want to achieve. So that is also one of the major advantage that you can go with our technology. So now we have completed the definition. Next is the composition and types of ingredients that any aerated concrete being used. So this is the composition. These are the different raw materials that are being used for creating this aerated concrete. So you can see one part of this aerated concrete is slurry part, and the other part is the foam part. So for making the slurry, you normally use water, Portland cement, and then the filler. So this filler can be anything. Like I said, it should be very fine aggregate, and we always recommend to use fly ash if it is available locally, or any slag. And if you don't get these finer aggregates, then you can go with sand. But you cannot use the normal sand, but you need to use very, very fine sand, which has got the particle size less than 1 millimeter diameter. So apart from these three ingredients, you can also use our additives. As I said earlier, network former, stabilizer and all, you can use those additives. So all these four mixed together forms a slurry. And then separately, there will be foam will be generated using, as I said, air, water and the foaming chemical. So we use foaming agent lithofoam SL200L. So once you mix these three, you will get the foam, and this foam and slurry is mixed together and form lithopore aerated concrete. So this is the basic composition of this lithopore aerated concrete. And these are the different chemical additives that we normally supply. So in the foaming agent, we have two different types of foaming agent, lithofoam SL200L and lithofoam SL250L. So 200 and 250L basically has got different compositions. These foaming agents are used for different applications. I will let you know later for what purposes SL200L is being used, SL250L is used. So for major applications, majority of the applications, we normally use with SL200L. Only for specific conditions, we use lithofoam SL250L. So apart from this foaming agent, as I said, we also supply network former. So there are two different types of network former, lithofoam NWFS and lithofoam NWFNT. So this network former, basically, as I said, it will actually react only with our foaming agent, and it stabilizes the foaming agent. And other than that, we also have lithofoam MRF 2000S, which is the stabilizer, which we normally use it for very lightweight concrete, like below 300 kilogram per cubic meter. And also we have Lithoform CC. So Lithoform CC is basically an accelerator. Whenever you want to achieve the drying effect quicker, or when you have very cold temperature, then you can use this accelerator chemical. And then we have got Lithoform SPO, which is a hydrophobic agent. So this hydrophobic agent, once you mix this into this aerator concrete, it will repel the water whenever it comes or comes in contact with the aerated concrete. So basically this hydrophobic agent is used where you don't want this concrete to be absorbing the water at all. So for that particular applications, this Lithoform SPO is being used. So now we can see what is this foaming agent. As I said, there are different types of foaming agents available in the market. Extractor protein based foaming agent, and then you have chemical based foaming agent. And other than that, as I have said, we have artificial or engineered protein or synthetic protein. So what we do is basically our protein is a molecularly engineered protein, and it's basically it's a worldwide unique protein agent, foaming agent, because other than us, many are not using our technology for manufacturing this foaming agent. And as I said, it is a totally artificial protein. So, but still it is a totally degradable kind of a substance. And we basically in this foaming agent, we don't use only one particular substance. We use a compound based structure. Compound means there are so many other ingredients apart from this protein. So that's the main thing that takes care of the stability of the foam. So this is the foaming agent that we normally do. So next we can see about network former. So this network former, as I said, there are two types, NWFS and NWFNT. So NWFS is normally used for high strength, for increasing the strength of the aerated concrete. You can use this, and this chemical reaction, as I said, it is basically between the foam as well as this NWFS, and it actually enhances the hardening part of the concrete. And you can use this chemical for any lithopore aerated concrete density of above 200 kilogram per cubic meter. For anything below 200 kilogram per cubic meter, you will be using the next network former, which is NWFNT. So this is basically specialized to use it for very low density, because in very low density you will always face shrinkage problem. So this has got shrinkage reducing compounds, and so it reduces the shrinkage in the concrete, and also it retains the pore structure basically. So as I said, the foaming chemicals or the foam bubbles should be having very low diameter so that it will have a good stability. Excuse me. So this NWFNT is normally used for concrete above 75 kilogram per cubic meter and less than 200 kilogram per cubic meter. So far we have seen the different types of concrete and definition of this lightweight aerated concrete, and also the composition and types of ingredients. Now we are going to see the manufacturing process. So we know what all the ingredients that are being used. Now we see how it is being mixed and how it is being generated. So in this production of lithopore aerated concrete, at first we have this slurry. We will first make the slurry. So for that we need the slurry mixture. So in this slurry mixture, at first the water is being measured and then added into the slurry mixture. And next we add the cement. We also measure this cement using the scale, weighing scale, and then we add it into the slurry mixture. Once the water and cement is mixed together, then we use the other additives like metal former or stabilizer and all. So all these additives are also weighed and then being used. So once this water, cement or filler and the additives are mixed, then the foam is being there is one more additive, which is the stabilizer. So normally this stabilizer is very fine fibers which is mixed with the water, and this stabilizer is added together with the water content. So once this slurry is mixed and ready, then it will be transferred to the primary mixture so that the foam can be added in that. So you can see the size of the slurry mixture is very small, because the amount of the volume of slurry that we produce is very small. And only when you add the foam, it increases the volume, and that's how we reduce the weight of this concrete. So for that reason, we transfer this small slurry from smaller mixture to bigger mixture, which is the primary mixture. And in that, we add the foam along with the slurry. So this mixture mixes this foam as well as this slurry together. And for creating the foam, as I said, this is the foam generator that we normally supply. So this foam generator contains the air compressor, water pump, as well as the foaming agent suction pump. So once these three are mixed together, then it can produce the foam. And this foam is directly mixed along with the slurry in the primary mixture. So once the slurry and foam are mixed together thoroughly, then it will be poured. Now the aerated concrete is ready, so it will be poured inside the mold or anywhere that you want to pour it. I'll go through the applications. There are some applications that can be manufactured at the industrial plants, and there are applications where this concrete can be manufactured at site also. So that's the flexibility that this lithopore aerated concrete has got. Because in other technology like aerated autoclaved concrete technology, you have to produce only this concrete under industrial conditions. You cannot manufacture this autoclaved concrete in a site, because autoclaving chambers, you cannot carry it. You need to have a very high energy for that. So this aerated autoclaved concrete can be manufactured only under the industrial process and industrial plants. Whereas lithopore aerated concrete can be manufactured at plant as well as at site. So when you do that, you have further advantages of transportation and everything. So this is the typical lithopore aerated concrete block making plant looks like. So you can see here there are different parts of this plant. So the first part is the mixing part. So in the mixing part, you have got two silos. These silos, one you can store it with the cement, and the other one you can store it with the filler like fly ash or slag. And from these silos, directly it will get the raw materials are weighed, and then using the weigh batching system, you can weigh different ingredients, as I said, water, cement, filler and other additives. You can weigh it, and then you can add it into the slurry mixture. So this first part of this mixture is the slurry mixture, wherein all these ingredients for slurry is being mixed, and then it is being pumped into the primary mixture. So the primary mixture is on top. You can see on top of this thing. So there the slurry is being pumped, as well as the foam generator is also being pumped inside the primary mixture. So after the foam and slurry is mixed thoroughly, then it will be discharged into the discharge mixture. So the next stage of mixture is the discharge mixture, wherein this concrete is stored till it is filled inside the mold. By the time it is filling the molds, the next batch of aerated concrete is being produced automatically. So like I said, there are three different stages of mixing. One is the slurry mixing stage on the bottom. This is the slurry mixing, and then it is pumped into the primary mixture, wherein in primary mixture the slurry and foam is being mixed together, and then it is transferred to the discharge mixture. So when the concrete is stored inside the discharge mixture, the next batch of aerated concrete starts producing. So once the concrete is mixed, you will be filling that inside the molds. So here you can see there are lots of rails, and in those rails there are lots of mold rails. Molds are stored, and in these molds the concrete is filled. These molds are basically very big size. They are of 0.8 to 1 cubic meter capacity. So once these molds are filled with this aerated concrete, then it starts drying, and once it dries after 6 to 8 hours, then the side plates are being removed and it is fed into the cutting system. So next, after the molds are dried, then the bigger blocks are sent inside this cutting system. There are 3 or 4 towers inside this cutting system. So each tower cuts it in different directions. The first tower will cut the top and bottom of the bigger blocks, and then the next cutting will take place in longitudinal direction, and then the third one will take care of the transverse direction. So by the time all these towers are crossed, the blocks are cut into smaller size, or whatever size that you want to achieve, that you can cut it. And afterwards, it is being stored inside these curing chambers. These curing chambers are not like autoclaves. They are simple curing system wherein you use the steam under normal atmospheric pressure. So you will not create the steam under very high pressure like in autoclaving chambers. Whereas this concrete is cured under normal atmospheric pressure, and so you will maintain the temperature of around 60 to 70 degrees inside this chamber. Whereas in autoclaved concrete, they maintain the temperature above 100 degrees centigrade. So normally it will be around 150 to 200 degrees centigrade. They will maintain it, whereas here we maintain the temperature of 60 to 70 degrees with the using the steam. So this steam accelerates the curing process as well as the hardening effect of the blocks, and so you can you know, just keep it for 7 days inside the factory for complete drying, and then you can pack it for your client to supply them. So on the left bottom, you can see the curing chambers. There are different levels of curing chambers inside which these molds are being stored, and then the steam is being passed in that. So here also we use around 10 hours of curing with the steam, and afterwards it is packed in the pallets and then sent it to the customer. So for production of this lithopore aerated concrete, these are the equipments that we normally supply to the clients. So like I said, our machines are complete systems. So one of the system is a mobile version. Mobile version means you can take this machine to the site and you can create or manufacture the lithopore aerated concrete under the site condition also. So here you can see this is the machine, which we call it as lithopore station. So in this lithopore station, you have many different parts. So you have 1 cubic meter capacity of mixing. So this is the mixture where the slurry and the foam is being mixed together. And then this part, the front part of the machine has got foam generation, and this dark blue longitudinal lengthwise thing is the pump. So this concrete pump, after it is being mixed, it will pump the aerated concrete directly to the molds or to the formwork, wherever you want to do. So basically in this system, you will be manually weighing all the ingredients. There is no automatic weigh batching system in this mobile version. Whereas in plant version, you have the automatic automatic weigh batching system. So in this mobile version, you can also have the screw conveyors for transferring this cement or fly ash or sand. And you can see here directly, this is feeding inside the mixture. And so that's how the concrete is mixed and poured into the molds. This is also the mobile version, but it's a truck trailer based, aerated concrete manufacturing process. So in this truck trails, you can keep this machine always under the trailer of the truck. And here, as I said, there are three different stages of mixing. So in the second picture on top, in the middle picture on top, you can see there are two blue mixtures. So the smaller one is the slurry mixture, wherein you will mix the water, cement, fly ash, or the filler along with the additives. And then it is mixed into the primary mixture, which is the bigger mixture that you have on the left side of this picture. So in that, you will be mixing the slurry as well as the foam. And on the third picture on top, you can see there is a different area for storing the chemicals as well as the water. So in the trailer, you can see on the end, the mixing systems are there, or the equipments are there. And we also supply the diesel generator for supplying the power to the mixtures. We also supply, there is a separate storage for chemicals as well as the water. And there is also a provision in between these two chambers. There is a provision for storing the cement also. So you can see here on the fourth picture on the bottom leftmost corner, you can see there are two trucks that are standing. So the right one is for manufacturing the aerated concrete. The left one is the cement supply tank or supply truck. So whatever the cement that is being transported, it will be filled inside the silo in the truck, and so they are transferring the cement, and then the cement is being used for producing the concrete. So the major advantage in this truck trailer based equipment is that you can continuously produce the concrete. You don't have to wait in between the batches. So you can actually continuously produce this concrete using this truck trailers. Whereas the previous one, this mobile version, Lithopo station, you had to produce batch by batch. So first you make 1 cubic meter of concrete, you will be weighing everything, and then you mix it, and then you pump it. Once you empty the mixture, then only you can start the next batch. So it will take very long time for each batch to produce. Whereas in truck trailer based lithoporated concrete technology, you can produce the lithoporated concrete continuously. So the next version that we supply is the RMC version. So normally, if you take any RMC plant, they have the silos for storing the raw materials. They have fly ash, they have cement, and they also have sand if you want. So what we do is, in those RMC plants, we actually supply the foam generation system as well as the material, raw material feeding pump. So along with the other system, they will be using, they will be having, the RMC plants are having this foam generator, so that they can use this foam inside their actual concrete mixture that they are using, and so that's how they can produce this aerated concrete and supply this concrete through the truck mixture. So you can see in these pictures, in the RMC plant, this aerated concrete is produced and then it is supplied to through the truck mixture, and then it is being pumped inside the buildings. So you can see this is the filling application. They are filling this concrete on the floor, and then it is being leveled afterwards. So this is another type of concrete production, lithoporated concrete production. And now we can see the properties of this concrete. So this is one of the very important thing to know, what kind of properties this concrete has got. So here you can see the first property is the compressive strength property. So as I said, this aerated lithoporated concrete is mainly used for non-structural applications. So you cannot expect very high strength in this concrete. So you can see for different densities, there are different compressive strength that you can achieve. So in this, you have two different curves. So the red one is a mixture of cement and fly ash. The blue one is the mixture of cement and sand. So you can see the ingredients that are used with cement and fly ash will achieve very high strength for the same density, whereas the cement and sand mixture will achieve a little bit lower density. So if you take 600 density, you can see using sand you can achieve 2.5, whereas with the fly ash you can, for the same 600 density, you can achieve 3.25. And when you increase the densities, you can see the strength is also increasing. So you can choose the density of this concrete, and depending on the strength that you need or depending on the application that you want. So if you want a little bit higher strength, then you can increase the densities of this concrete. And if you want more of thermal properties, you can reduce the density. In the next thing, you can see here. So this thermal conductivity properties are totally opposite to the compressive strength. So when you want high strength, you will be increasing the densities, whereas if you want a higher insulation property, then you will be going down. So any concrete that has got very low weight has got very good very low thermal conductivity value and a very high thermal insulation value. So this is what is showing in this chart. So if you see, high densities concrete has got higher thermal conductivity values, and the lower density concrete has got lower thermal conductivity value. So the lower thermal conductivity is good for insulation, whereas the higher thermal conductivity is not useful for insulation. So the next most important thing is the water absorption. So you may think that since this concrete has got more pores, this may absorb lots of moisture, but in lithopore aerated concrete, that is the most advantage. Even though there are millions of pores inside this concrete, the water absorption of this concrete is very low when compared to even the clay bricks. So if you take clay brick water absorption as 100%, it will absorb only 35% of the total water. So if one brick absorbs 1 liter of water, this lithopore foam concrete absorbs only 0.35 liters or only 350 milliliters of water only it will absorb. So that's how I have compared. Whereas the other technology that I said, aerated autoclaved concrete block, absorbs double this volume. You can see it absorbs 70% of water. The reason why the lithopore aerated concrete is absorbing lesser amount of water and why aerated autoclave concrete absorbs more water is because all these bubbles or the foam based cellular concrete, it all has got closed cell properties. So you can see in this slide that I have shown earlier, you can see here all these pores, there is no interconnection between one pore to the another pore, it's all closed. So this is the main reason why the water is not absorbed apart from the surface. So only the surface part of this concrete absorbs the moisture because the surface part has got open pores, whereas when if you go inside, if you cut this slab inside, all these cells are totally closed structure. Whereas in aerated autoclaved concrete, they use this aluminium powder. So what happens in once this aluminium powder mixes with the cement or water, it produces a hydrogen gas. So this gas is the one that creates the bubbles, and it also, what happens is this gas also escapes out of this concrete. So when it escapes out of this concrete, it creates a kind of a interconnection between these pores, and so that's why it is absorbing lots of moisture. Whereas in aerated autoclave, in lithopore aerated concrete, these interconnection is totally negligible or zero, and so the water absorption is very less compared to the aerated concrete. So this is water absorption property. Next is the fire resistance. This is very important. You can see in this chart normal concrete of you can say 150 millimeter thick. So the x-axis is thickness of the concrete, the y-axis is fire resistance time. So if you see in the foam concrete or lithopore aerated concrete of 1100 kilogram per cubic meter density, to take a 100 millimeter thickness, the 100 millimeter thickness concrete of lithopore aerated concrete will resist for at least 3.5 hours of fire, whereas the same 100 millimeter thickness of normal concrete resist only 1 or 1.1 hours of fire. So the reason being, as I said, the higher density always conducts the heat very easily. So whenever the building is comes under fire, the high density concrete will be quicker to pass this heat inside the rooms, whereas the foam concrete, because of this pores, it takes very long time to conduct the heat. So that's how when there is a building under fire, you can have very longer time to escape out of the fire, so that you will not come under fire very quickly. So next very good property of this concrete is the workability and durability. As you can see, this concrete, you can cut it even with the wooden saw. It's so light, it is very easy to cut even with the wooden saw. You can cut it, and you can use the screws or drill or anything you want, and you can easily chase cut for the electrical pipelines. So you can see here, it's very easy to chase cut these for the pipelines, and it also has got very good sound insulation property. So because of this pores, the sound is not passed very easily through these walls. And as I said, it's very good for thermal insulation and fire resistance. So these are the different advantages of using this lithopore aerated concrete. The first major advantage is the economical in construction. This economy can be done in two ways. One is by reducing the dead load. You know, normally if you use in the residential apartments, if you take 10 or 20 storied buildings, the walls are the major dead loads. And if you use a normal clay brick in those walls, you know, it has got the density of around 1800 kilogram per cubic meter, whereas the wall that are being constructed with lightweight concrete is just 600 kilogram per cubic meter, which is 1/3 of the weight. So you are reducing 2/3 dead load of this whole building. So when you are reducing the dead load, automatically the load that are being transferred to the beams as well as to the columns are reduced tremendously. So because of that, your whole structural concrete requirement as well as the steel requirement reduces tremendously. And so in the foundation, you can save a lot using this lightweight concrete bricks or blocks. And the second thing is that these blocks being very big size, normally each block will have 600 millimeters length and 200 millimeter height, and you can have 100 millimeter thickness or 200 millimeter thickness. So this 600 by 200 by 200 millimeter one block is equal to around 11 bricks. So if you place one block, you are actually placing 11 bricks at a time. So this saves the labor cost as well as the mortar cost in between the plaster the thing. And also these blocks are uniform in size, so your plastering thickness will be reduced tremendously. And that's also another cost saving part apart from the structural cost saving. So the next advantage is because of this lighter weight and good strength, you know, this is you know, useful for construction of floors, partitions and external cladding. And this can save considerably in those frame structures because of this lighter weight, as I said earlier. And it's very easier to build as well as it is economical to transport also. Because of its lightweight, you can transport more blocks with the same transport vehicles. And since it has got very good thermal insulation, you can save tremendously the air conditioning or heating cost when you use these blocks as a wall, because it will not transfer the external temperature to the internal room temperature very easily. So it resists the temperature strongly. So your air conditioning time and energy will be saved because of that. And the next advantage is it is totally environmental friendly, because all these ingredients, the cement or foaming agent or the fly ash, everything you can recycle and you reuse this again. So that's the major advantage of using our technology. So that's why we have been certified as a Blue Angel technology. This is a German environmental labeling certification, eco label certification authority. So anyone that uses our technology, they can be certified as Blue Angel technology thing. So this means basically that our products emit very low pollutants, and also it doesn't have adverse impact on the health of the human beings in the nature. So, and the next advantage is fire resistance. As I have said, using this concrete, you can have higher fire resistance up to 4 hours. And it also has got very good sound insulation. So the last part that we are going to see is the application part, which is a very interesting one. So far, whatever we have seen, unless you don't know for what purpose it is being used, you will not have you will not appreciate this concrete. So we can see there are so many different applications that I'm going to show you, which is very interesting. So the first and foremost is the infilling of these hollow blocks. Normally, you know, these hollow blocks that we normally use, These hollow blocks, are used in European countries for insulation purpose. So if you leave that hollow with the empty or air, then their insulation is a little bit lower. Whereas if you infill that hollow part with our aerated autoclave, with our lithopore aerated concrete of density 75 to 150 kilogram per cubic meter, you will get very high thermal insulation properties, and so it adds the insulation value of this hollow blocks of the in the building. And so the second application that I we can see is the you can see insulation layer for basement. Basically, in European countries, because of this cold climate, the coldness, the chillness will come from the floor also. So any building that are being constructed, they first have to insulate the ground. So for insulating the ground, earlier they were using various different products. Now we have replaced that with our lithopore aerated concrete, because it is very quick to do it. You can see, you can bring this truck to any site. You can just produce this concrete and pour continuously and fill it with the whatever thickness that you want. And then you can finish it. And once you finish it, you can use the normal foundation or any foundation that you can use it for building the structure. So this is one of the advantage or application that you can use it. So then the next application is the insulation panels. So these insulation panels basically are used on the walls. So apart from the walls that you normally construct with the bricks or any other walling material, you will be sticking these lithopore insulation panels. So these insulation panels have got the dry density of just 150 kilogram per cubic meter. And so you can use it externally or internally also. You can stick these panels on the external walls. You can see here, after sticking these panels, there are different other layers like waterproofing layer and finishing layer, and all it will be applied on top of this insulation panels. So this is another application that you can use it for. And this is very interesting. You can use this concrete for permeable concrete. You can use this lithopore aerated concrete as permeable concrete. We have a specialized chemicals for producing this concrete. What happens is that basically, once you can see, I think you can see here, the water is being poured on top of this concrete and all the water is drained out on the bottom. So it's very quick. You can see the drainage process is very quick. So this is majorly used for rainwater storage in the open surface. So if you want to drain the rainwater quickly onto the underground storage, then you can use this concrete as a permeable concrete. So you can see this density is just 250 to 300 kilogram per cubic meter, and it has got tremendous drainage capacity. So next is the standard blocks. So this is commonly used in India. So for any multi-storied building where you use the framed structure, so wherever the beams and columns are taken care of by the loads are taken care of by these beams and columns, the wall is just the filling material. So in those framed structures, these blocks can be used as a wall, so that it will have, as I said, it reduces the dead load first of all. And it is, since the block size is very big, you can construct it at a very faster rate, and it reduces the mortar, binding mortar, and also it's very quick to construct. And since it is a smoother surface, the plastering also, it's very easy. And So it has got multiple advantages of using this concrete as a block. So in India, this type of concrete is tremendously used as a block. And you can also produce interlocking blocks. So you can see here, for the same blocks, here the only disadvantage is that you need to have a binding mortar to bind this thing, whereas in the interlocking blocks, in the interlocking blocks, you don't need any binding mortar. You will just use this interlocking arrangement in the blocks, so that it automatically locks the block. And what you do is, basically you can see there is a hole in the middle of those blocks. So you arrange these blocks and then you pour concrete inside these holes so that it acts as a column, and so it binds together all these blocks. So that's how you can see in the construction process, once they stack these blocks, they actually have the rods in between these blocks, and they fill the concrete in that small holes so that it keeps the wall stable. So the next very important and very useful application is the casted site filling. So here, this is a G plus one structure, which is constructed using light gauge steel frames. So what they did is, after the plinth level is over, they put these steel frames on top of this plinth, and then they fix the cement board on the external side. Once they fix the cement board, then they do this plumbing and wiring, electrical wiring inside. These pipelines are being fixed, and then they put another cement board on the other side also. So in between these two cement boards, they fill this concrete, this lightweight concrete, and this actually gives a very good effect of solid wall, because if you use only cement boards, then it will sound a very hollow sound, you will get it. So no one will feel safe with the hollow soundness, because it is easily, anyone can damage that board easily. Whereas once you fill this concrete, it is very solid in nature, so it is more safer, and also it gives very good thermal insulation and sound insulation properties. And because this boards are very smooth in nature, you can just putty the boards and then you can paint it easily. So this way of construction is very faster. You can this G plus one structure, you can finish it within 1 or 1.5 months very easily. So that's how the advantage of this concrete is. And earlier we have seen this finished with boards. So in this application, this is also cast at site, but it's an exposed concrete. We use formworks for this type of houses. So you can see there are the red one is the formwork. So you know the formwork, wall formwork. You have both sides the formwork, and then you fill this concrete in between the formworks. And after 1 or 2 days, you can remove this formwork and you can have the walls ready. So this is also one of the faster way of doing it. And since the formwork is very smooth in nature, you don't need to plaster it afterwards. You can directly apply the putty and you can paint it. And it is also very faster in construction, and which is very economical, because when you fill this concrete, your wall will be ready within 24 to 48 hours. So the next application is precast sandwich panels. So you know, in conventional concrete, there are precast panels, wall panels, you can manufacture it and you can bring that to site and you can build the walls. So similarly, as you know, the normal concrete panels are very heavy, and also it has got very low thermal insulation. In between two small thickness of concrete panels, you can sandwich with the lightweight lightweight aerated concrete panel also. So what happens in this is that you will be manufacturing these panels under a factory setup, and then you bring this whole wall, entire wall, into the site, and you will be fixing these panels and joining it in the site, and you will construct this buildings in weeks. Earlier we saw in months. Now within a week you can construct the walls very easily. So this is the precast wall panel using light gauge steel frames. So here you have seen, this is under site condition. You fix all the frames on the site, whereas here you can see the panels made with the light gauge steel frames on the factory setup. So what they do is they make the complete wall with the frames, and then they fill these frames with the lithopore aerated concrete, and it will be transported to the site, and then you can fix it. So this is also another way of doing it, with the same light gauge steel frames with the cement boards on both sides. You can precast it as well as you can do cast at site. So both these constructions are very fast in constructions, and so it has got very good quality of construction. You don't have to use any cement at all at the site. So all this construction is dry construction. So you can fix all these frames very quickly. So next is the panel production. You can directly cast this concrete as wall panels. We have a customer in the UK as well as in China, where they manufacture the entire walls with the lightweight concrete, but it is reinforced. It has got reinforcement inside, and it will be precast at the factory and brought it to the site. And using cranes, they, like here you can see the cranes are used to fix this panels, and then you will be constructing it at a very faster pace. So the next application is precast sandwich facade elements. So what they do is, as I said, in insulation panels that we have seen, normally the insulation panels are stick on the external part of the walls. So along with the insulation panels, you can also make this type of decorative elements. So you can actually, these are the different thin tiles that are being pasted on the insulation panel itself. So you can directly apply these panels on the walls, existing walls. So what they do is, there is an existing insulation, lightweight concrete insulation panels, and on that the tiles are fixed on that, and then it is directly applied on the external walls. So you don't have to plaster it. You will get the external wall finish of whatever design that you want. You can have a brick design or different stone designs. So many designs you can directly do it. This is a very faster way of finishing the walls, as well as it takes care of the insulation also. So normally this type of application is used in Turkey and China. Next is the screeding applications. So as I said earlier, you can manufacture this concrete in RMC plants. So once you manufacture it and bring it to the site, you can directly pour this concrete on floors as well as for the roofs. So you can see here in Europe, normally all the service lines like water line and electricity lines are all laid on the floor, whereas in India and other Asian countries, they normally do it on the walls as well as on the roof. all these pipelines. In European and Western countries, they lay these pipelines on the bottom, on the floors. So to fill this pipelines, to do that, they need to screed. They need to pour the screed on top of it. So instead of using the heavier aggregate screed, you can use this lightweight concrete screed. And normally the density is in the range of 400 to 800. Sometimes you can go even up to 200 kilogram per cubic meter, so that it gives a very good insulation effect on top of the building. If you are doing it for roof insulation, you can use that. So what they do is they fill this till the top of this pipelines, and then they level it. So you can see here, once the leveling is over, then they fix the tiles or any flooring that you want to do, you can do on top of this lightweight concrete. So as I said, this is the roof insulation. For any building that we have nowadays, the top floor of the apartment buildings, they experience lots of heat coming directly from the roof. So to avoid those heat, you can lay this concrete on top of the conventional concrete slab, and then you can finish it with the roof tiles. So this will give very good thermal insulation property, and it is tremendously useful for Middle East as well as in Indian climatic conditions. This is another very unique and very specific application. So this is called pipe cementing. What it does is basically in the municipality or in corporation, we have a bigger diameter of water pipes laid on the road. So if there is any damage to these pipes, it's very difficult to replace that pipe with the new pipe, because there is always traffic on the road. So you need to avoid, you need to stop those traffic to work on these repair works. So instead, what they do is they insert a smaller diameter pipe. So the original old pipe is 1000 millimeter, whereas the new pipe is 900 millimeter or 930 millimeter thickness, diameter. So they insert it, and then what they do is there is a gap in between the older and the newer pipe. So this gap is being filled with this lithopore concrete. So this outer layer is the older pipe, and the inner layer is the new pipe, and in between they fill this with the lightweight concrete, so that this pipe, the whole thing will act as a one single pipeline. So this kind of pipe cementing, you can do it with this lightweight concrete. In India, it's not widely used, but in European countries, they do such kind of work. So next application is a road subbase or walkway. So whenever you lay a new road or highway or anything, you have to first prepare the subbase. So normally in India, they use lots of soil, like fly ash or any waste material they use. But the disadvantage in those things is that you need to compact it, you need to bring it to the stabilized layer, so that the road can be built on top of it. Whereas if you use lightweight concrete, you can directly apply this concrete on the roads, or even you can use it as a walkway. And on top of this subbase, you can build the normal road, so that there won't be any settlement happening in the, even though you can think that it is having very low strength, but because of its solid nature, it actually acts as a very good subbase. So for those applications, you you can use the dry density between 800 to 1400 kilogram per cubic meter. It will have sufficient strength as well as lighter weight, and since it can be directly poured on the site, you can easily do it at site. So these are the advantages of using this concrete in road, subways or walkway. And the next application is geofilling. So geofilling, you know, wherever there is a gap in the hilly areas or any of the road building or tunneling, in those thing there is a gap between the hills as well as the construction part. So here you can see they have constructed a multi-storied apartments on the hilly area. So when you do it, there is always gap in between the rock as well as the building. So to avoid any damage to the building whenever there is a movement of rock or something like that, or to avoid any danger of falling inside the gaps, so they need to fill this gap with screed concrete. So instead of using any other screed concrete, lightweight concrete is very effective because it fills every nook and corner, because this concrete is very fluid in nature. It's like more of a water kind of a thing. So it fills every nook and corner. It completely seals off everything. And so it's very useful for such type of geofilling applications. The next application is sound wall. So in highways, basically in Western countries, because these highways are used with the high speed vehicles, they constantly create lots of noise. So to avoid that noise coming inside the residential area, they construct this sound wall along with the highway. So here this is one such type of sound wall. It is being constructed. So they have this pillars, and in between the pillar they have slided the wall panels. So if you use these wall panels with the lightweight concrete, it has got very good sound insulation property, and so it is used as a sound wall for highway construction. And this is another unique application, which is called bullet trap. You know, in artillery, in police training or in army training, they always practice, the soldiers or the police practice the gun, you know, practice, or they practice with the heavy artillery or heavy guns practice. So they shoot at a target, and beyond this target, these bullets need to be captured so that it will be safely disposed of. So for that, they used to have sand-based walls on so that the bullets will trap inside the sand and then they can take it. But instead of using any other material, if you use this lightweight concrete, it easily traps the bullet. At the same time, you can demolish it quickly and you can do it. So for those type of bullet traps, you can use this concrete. So the last application is decorative elements. So since this concrete is very light in weight, you can see there are lots of parts available in concrete which is very heavy. Whereas if you use this lightweight concrete, you can do lots of decorative elements with the lighter in weight, so that it can be easily applied. For example, these tiles kind of thing, or stamping kind of application, you can do it with this lightweight concrete, so that you can directly paste it on the walls. Or you can directly use this heavier concrete pots for plant storing or for growing plants. So for such type of concrete balustrades, you can use concrete balustrades for elevation of the buildings and all. So all those decorative elements whatever the concrete that you are using, conventional concrete, you can replace that with the lightweight concrete also, so that it is very easy to handle. At the same time, it's more appealing to see it. So that's all. I have almost completed everything. If you need any clarifications or any doubts, you can ask. Thank you.
Hi sir, can I ask a question? Am I audible?
Yeah, please. Yeah.
Oh, thank you for the interesting presentation. I have one or two questions. Firstly, what is the lowest thermal conductivity of the insulation panel? You know, the insulation panel product. What is the lowest thermal conductivity we can make using this technology?
You can see in my presentation, the lowest is using the density of 75 kilogram per cubic meter, you can achieve 0.046 watts per meter Kelvin.
And this 75, can we make it as a panel or should it be filled in the cavity?
Normally, you can
the insulation panel you are showing it.
Sorry.
Yeah, because in the insulation panel you have showed the density of 150. So that's why my question. In the insulation panel slide, it was 150 density, not 75.
Yeah, so this 75 basically it was filled in the hollow blocks. Whereas if you use it for insulation panels, it will be having around 100 to 150 kilogram per cubic meter. Below that, it's very difficult because the panels will be very very complicated to handle it. So if you want to use 75 kilogram per cubic meter, you need to directly fill it in the cavities. So if you make a sandwich walls or something like that, then you can directly fill it with the 75 kilogram per cubic meter. But if you want to use it as a panels, then it is better to use it as at 150 kilogram per cubic meter. That's mainly to handle, because the 75 kilogram per cubic meter panels is more brittle. You know, it's very delicate to handle it, so it breaks very easy.
Yeah.
So that's why we normally use it for direct filling of this.
Thank you very much. Secondly, will you say more about the curing condition? How much will be the humidity we should keep for 60 to 70 degrees Celsius for 7 days? What about the humidity? Temperature is 60 to 70, but what will be the humidity condition?
And this 60 to 70 degrees is normally done using steam only. So whatever the curing chamber that we have, it's a steam curing chamber. So obviously any steam is always above 100 degrees and it has got water content. So it's 100% humidity.
Okay,
100%. So there should not be any issue. Yeah, because if you use only hot air, then concrete cracks very easily. So that's why you need to do it with the steam, so that it keeps the temperature high as well as it keeps the moisture content.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the wonderful session. And I request all the participants to fill the feedback form posted in the chat box. And thank you, sir. Thank you for your wonderful session. And it's a pleasure to have you with us today. And now I request our student Neha to deliver the vote of thanks. Neha?
Yes, ma'am. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Yes, ma'am. Warm greetings to the respected guest speaker of the session, respected HOD, faculties of civil and other department of SVC, and my dear friends. This is Neha from third year civil engineering. It's an honor and privilege to extend vote of thanks on this occasion. On behalf of the Department of Civil Engineering, I would like to thank our guest speaker, Mr. Sivaram Kumar for taking his precious time out and consenting to be the guest speaker. Sir, indeed, your lecture was very informative and thought-provoking. We have been fortunate enough to be backed up by our beloved head of department, Professor R. Kumuda. She has been a constant moral support and guidance. A special thanks to our faculty coordinator of the session, Professor K. Satyapriya. Thank you all.
Thank you, Neha. And thank you, Sachin. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.